Are you saying that the New York Times will no longer be a newspaper?
It will change shape. I think we'll be a newspaper for another quarter century.
So we call over to 229 West 43rd Street and tell them we've only got 25 more years?
That's right.
That's astounding.
Well, they know that.
Max Frankel, who used to be the executive editor of the New York Times Company when you were publisher and when you were president.
I was his copy boy at one point.
Well, you were 2 years ago in the inaugural program, which this is also, said the New York Times on paper is dead. In 20 years from now, the daily paper will only be retrievable from a website. And in 50 years, the Sunday Times will be gone. Do you agree with that statement, Russ Lewis?
No.
So now, I don't know where that came from.
Well, that came from the New York Times. That's what they said.
I'll have to talk to the New York Times.
And joining us tonight is the enemy, Martin London, who sues media companies. He is a partner at Paul Weiss and is a well-known litigation attorney. Marty, why are the courts shooting the messenger?
I don't believe the courts are shooting the messenger. That's number one. Number two, the messenger has become more outrageous, more greedy, more arrogant.
With respect to Watergate, you had a source, an important source, and you didn't know who it was.
I took him into
him.
I took Woodward.
Oh,
him,
Woodward.
Yeah, into the neighborhood park, put him on a bench, and said, "Who is he?" And he told me, and that's the end of it.
How about President Kennedy? President Kennedy had numerous affairs, including one in the White House itself, which we found out about later. Now, suppose that you found out of them not later, but when he was president.
Look, Jim, these are hypothetical questions. I don't know.
lawyers are tough. Let me talk about Henry Hyde just for a moment.
And Harry Evans, the former head of Random House, the former editor-in-chief, the husband of Tina Brown, you know, a rarefied Brit with intensely, you know, highbrow sensibilities.
Wrong.
No, if
Harry's father was a motorman in Yorkshire. Harry went to work when he was about 17.
That doesn't mean that Harry.
What is your father? Harry went to work when he was about 17 years old.
But look, it's a.
And the notion that Harry is some highfalutin, polished Oxonian is a laugh. Well,
I mean, Ed has a sterling reputation, and you know he has created high levels of buzz and low levels of buzz. So, you know,
we'll medium buzz. Moderate buzz.
And medium and moderate
where
buzz.
Where did he create the high buzz?
Well, I think, you know, Ed, obviously, at New York Magazine, you know, you were huge and hot.
Why can't you make the Daily News more like the Post?
Well, primarily because we don't want to. We don't want to be like the Post. The Post is a newspaper of entertainment rather than of news.
Did God create everything except that one area?
Well, what's your position? I mean, your position is parents ought to look after the kids, but your position is that you can show at any time?
No, my position is that I believe that some of my programs should be shown all the time, of course. Programs that deal with education, programs that dispel homophobia.
Well, then let me ask you this. The only reason that we have that amendment to the Cable Act, which is at issue in your lawsuit. You sued because there was an amendment to the Cable Act that required putting these...
Scrambling
or banning.
Banning, okay?
Right.
And guess who did that? It was Jesse Helms who did that,
exactly.
Right?
His favorite topic.
And guess how he decided that he was going to put that amendment in effect? He looked at your programs, and he thought they were disgusting. Do the network anchors have some of them had facelifts?
I don't know. I really don't know. I know that some people other than the anchors have had. And if you really want to find out, you go and ask the makeup people at the networks.
This little idea is the driving force in a business now that takes in close to $1 billion. It's not the whole part of it, but it's the it's the driving force.
We'll pass $1 billion in revenue in January or February.
Here's what I don't understand. You leave Solomon Brothers, yep. and you're into equities, right? And you go over to this office with a coffee machine, yep. right? How does someone with a coffee machine and an equity background think that he can do these mathematical formulas, which you said a PhD would do otherwise? I don't get it.
America's a wonderful country. anything is possible. It really is true.
Why do you wear those silly hats?
We wear the silly hats, Jim, because, well, there are several reasons, but I'll give you the most relevant one. The most relevant one is that we challenge conventional wisdom. When we take a subject, in this case money, and we look at the various prevailing wisdoms out there, we like to challenge those.
Well, what happens when we take the cap off of Tom?
You know, what, can we do that briefly,
take
Tom?
This is why we don't do television.
Oh, okay. Tom,
that's why
on.
We don't do TV,
put
right
that
there.
That does hurt.
But I think we laugh at the idea of our being big media. I can't make a point without the cap on.
Yeah.
Okay, now you can talk again.
I don't really have anything to say now.
The difference between air conditioning and the internet is that the internet, it sort of lives like in dog years. You know how dog years are 8 times as fast as human years? The same way with air conditioning. The same way with air conditioning and the internet. The effect of the internet is occurring much faster than the effect of previous investments, but of previous great changes. But to think that it's different, I don't think that's the case. And I stick with what I said. I mean, air conditioning changed the world. The radio changed the world. All kinds of electricity, the telephone changed the world. Do I think that the internet is going to have a bigger effect on the way people live than the invention of the telephone did or the invention of electricity? I don't think so, no.
Thank you very much for the tutorial. Come back again. Patricia, thank you very much for coming in.
Very nice to meet you.
And thank you for joining us. Come back next week and learn more about the digital age.